Hello everyone, myself Dr. Arindo Sundar Das. I am working as assistant professor in Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering in Swami Vivekananda Institute of Science and Technology, Dakshin Govindapur, Kolkata. And this is my lecture number 6, okay, of the subject Control System and Instrumentation. And in last lecture, that is lecture number 5, I discussed about signal flow graph and Meissen's gain formula, from which we can find out transfer function of a complicated control system if we know the signal flow graph of the system. And that signal flow graph we can find out from the block diagram also, okay. So this is a very easy method to find out the transfer function of a complicated system, okay. Now let me just remind you the formula of Meissen gain formula, okay. The Meissen gain formula that we have to use of signal flow graph, which is derived by S.J. Meissen. The transfer function is nothing but summation of Pi delta I by delta, okay. And I told you what is the meaning of N is the number of forward path, Pi is the ith forward path, and delta is the determinant of the system, which equal to 0 if we put, that becomes the characteristic equation. From that we can find out poles location, and we can find out the, we can comment on the stability of the system. And delta I is the determinant of the ith forward path, okay. Delta, how we can find out, that is 1 minus individual loop gain, okay, then plus 2 non-touching loop gain, product of two non-touching loop gain. Then we can add, okay, if we have any other, then minus 3 non-touching loop gain, okay. If we have any more, then we can add that, then plus 4 non-touching loop gain, like that way. That is your delta, okay. And delta I equal to 1, okay, delta 1 equal to 1 if all loops are touching to forward path 1. If that is not the case, then delta 1 equal to 1 minus the loop value, which loop, the gain of the loop, which loop is not touching with forward path 1 or 2 or 3, whatever, okay. So this is how we can find out. So this is the Meissen's gain formula and how to find out that I have discussed now. Now let us, we have solved some problem in last lecture, that is around 8 problem we have solved. Now let us take another example of that, okay. After that I will solve another type of problem that we can do. So this is another problem, from block diagram we can draw. Now see, this is a very complicated block diagram, okay. We have a summer here, okay, two summation are there. So we have to, if you have to solve it, we have to do some manipulation here in this particular, if we apply block reduction technique. Now we can draw the its equivalent signal flow graph. So how, Rx is their input, then summer means 1, this is your S1, okay. Now here we are taking between this point and S2, T1, S2, we have G1. So between T1, S2, we have G1, okay. Between T1 and this S1, we have 1, okay. We have 1, because we have a takeoff point here, and we have a summer here, that is your S3, summer here, that is your S2, okay. Now after S2, we have G2, that is connected to T2. So after S2, G2 gain T2. From T2, H1 connected to S3, from, that is with negative sign, so minus H1, okay. And at S3, from this T1, G3 is connected. From 3, T1 plus G3 connected to S3, because it is plus sign, okay. And this summer is connected directly to S2, and this value should be 1, okay. And from T2, it is connected to H2 with a negative sign to this S1. So from T2 it is connected to S1, okay. and the value is minus H2. So this is the signal flow graph that is drawn from this particular block diagram. Only thing is this gain value are the branch gain, okay, and this summer and takeoff point, those are basically the nodes, that's all. Okay, now if you know this is the signal flow graph, we can look for your forward path. What is the forward path we can see? We can see here this is one forward path, fine, gain is G1, G2, and if you look here forward path, we can go like this way, we can go this way, and we cannot go this way because this is opposite direction. So we can go this way and we can reach, this is the forward path 2. One gain is G1, G2, second forward path gain is G3, G2, okay, T1, T2. Now we have to look for loop. What are the loop? So this is your overall loop, this is your loop 1, G1, G2 into minus H2. Then we can have a loop like, let me discard this lines and let me draw it. So what we can have this way, okay, we can have another loop, okay, this way. So this is G3 G2 minus H2, okay, L2, and we have another loop starting from this point and we can go like this way, okay. So G2 minus H1. So we have total 3 loops. So delta equal to what? 1 minus individual loop gain. So we get delta value. Now non-touching loop are not there because this is your loop 1. Okay. All these nodes are there. Loop 2, these two are common node. Okay, 3 nodes are common. For loop 3, these two are common. So they are not non-touching. So this is your delta. Now delta 1 and delta 2, if you want to find out. Delta 1 means this is your first forward path, all loops are touching with all the nodes, and this is your second forward path, we can see all the loops are touching with that, okay. So delta 1, delta 2, 1. So we can find out T1 into delta 1 plus T2 into delta 2, okay, divided by this delta value, okay. So if we put this value equal to 0, okay, and if you know what is the value of G1, G2, H2 in terms of S, Laplace transform of any system, then we can find out the pole location from this characteristic equation, and we can predict the stability from this characteristic equation or from the location of the pole. This is the example 1. Now let us take another example, okay. So we can go this way, this is your one forward path, and we can go this way, this is your another forward path. So we have two forward path, okay. This is the formula T1 delta 1 plus T2 delta 2 by delta. T1 is G1, G5, G6, G7, G8. T2 is G1, G2, G3, G4, G8. Okay, this is the value. Now what are the loops? We can see we have this is one loop and this is another loop. Okay, we don't have any other loop here, right? Only these two are the loops, these two are the feedback path, there is no other feedback path. So loop 1, loop 2, these are their gain. Now what you can see, this loop 1 and loop 2 are non-touching with each other because these nodes are not common for this loop 1 and loop 2, right? So what is the delta value now? 1 minus individual loop gain plus gain of two non-touching loop, okay. These two non-touching loop gain we have to multiply. So we have these two loop gain, then multiplication of these two become plus, so this is the factor. So this is your delta. Now we have to find out delta 1, okay. Now what is the value of delta 1? That means if this is your forward path 1, okay, then what we can see, this loop is touching with this forward path, that but loop, this loop is not touching with forward path. Then what we can write, 1 minus L2, that will be 1 plus G3 into H3, right? So that is your delta 1, okay. So delta 1 is this factor, this is your T1, and delta 1 is 1 plus G3 H3. And if you have the forward path, second forward path, if you consider the, sorry, if you consider this one as your second forward path, okay, then we can see this loop is not touching with this forward path. So delta 2 will be equal to what? 1 minus L1, 1 minus this loop which is not touching with that forward path. So what you can write? 1 plus G6 H6, right? G6 H6 with the negative sign, so negative negative become plus. This is 1 plus G6 H6, okay. We are getting this one is delta 2, this one as delta 1, and delta is already known, so this will be your transfer function. So that we can find out very easily, right? Only using the Mason-Skin formula, okay. Now let us solve another type of problem, okay. That is, if we know a system is given, okay. This is an example. This is an example of a circuit consist of RC network, okay. Say you have to find out the transfer function of the given network, okay. This is another type of problem that we can solve using this technique, signal flow graph using Mason's gain formula, okay. Now how to do that? Let me explain you that. So this is the network, okay. Now in this network what we can see or what we can observe is that R and C, this R1 and C are in parallel, okay, and we can assume that in this loop we have a current flowing IS, okay, and this is the voltage drop across R2 is your V0, okay. So we can take the Laplace transform because we have to find out transfer function, so we have to consider Laplace transform of that. Transfer function is the ratio of Laplace transform of output to Laplace transform of input when initial condition equal to 0, okay. So Laplace transform of C, what we can write? 1 by SC, okay. That is your Laplace transform of C. R1 is similarly R2 is sim R2, VI is VIS, V0S, I0S, and we can assume this current, that is IS, okay. Now this is the circuit, okay. Now we can find out what is the value of this equivalent impedance of this parallel R1 and 1 by SC1, okay, 1 by SC. So if we consider R and C in parallel, we can solve it for that. What is the formula? R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2, okay. Now if you solve it, what you will get? R1 divided by 1 plus R1 SC. That is the equivalent impedance of this R and C in Laplace transform. So this is your Z now, impedance, okay. This value is this, fine. Now we can write KVL equation, okay, for this particular loop. So what we can write? This IS equal to what we can write? Say let us write IS means what? We can write that IS is flowing this way through this Z, okay. So IS will be equal to what we can write? If we write KCL, okay, at this particular node, so IS, this one, if you consider, what we can write? IS current flowing through this way. So what we can write? VI minus V0 divided by Z, right? This is your IS that is flowing through this direction, means this is the same current flowing. So here this current IS, if with respect to VI V0, this IS value same as this IS, isn't it? Because this is in series, we are taking voltage across this R2, that is your output voltage V0, okay. So current is not dividing, this circuit is open. So this IS equal to VI minus V0 divided by Z, okay. So Z value we know, that we can put. So this is the equation, and V0 is equal to what? Drop across this resistance, that is I into R, so IS into R2. So this is your another equation. So from this simple network we got two equations, okay. This is your equation 1 and this is your equation 2. Now what we know? We know that if we want to draw the signal flow graph, okay, the nodes are basically the variable, okay, or the signal, nodes and branch gain, okay, then what we can write, if this node is B, this node is A, then B equal to A into S, output equal to input node value into the gain, that is B equal to A S. Now this concept we have to apply to draw the signal flow graph of these two equation. So what we can write, there I S means I equal to what? Vi into this factor minus V0 into this factor. So I S equal to, so what we can take, we can take one node here, that is I, okay, this is equal to what? Vi into this factor. So Vi can be taken as another node, and this factor can be your gain, that is your 1 by Z, okay. So I equal to Vi into this factor, right. Now we have minus V0 into this, that is equal to Is, okay, after we have to do subtraction. So what we can take another node here, that is your V0, okay, and we can take branch which is connected to I, and that direction we can give as minus of that 1 by Z, okay. So what we can see here, I equal to what we can write, Vi into this, then minus V0 into this. So this is the equation that we from that we can draw this particular signal flow graph. I equal to Vi into this factor, okay, and here it is V0 into minus of this factor. So total I equal to what? Vi minus V0 into this factor, okay, Z, 1 by Z actually. Z equal to R1 by 1 plus R1 Cs, this is 1 plus SR1 C by R1, okay, this is 1 by Z. So this is the signal flow graph that we are getting from this particular equation. Now for second equation, what we can have, this is very simple, because we have I, V0S equal to Is into R2. So we have V0 at the output side, input is Is multiplied by R2, okay. This is your R2, and here the input node is I, okay. So what are the circuit parameter value, IV, those we have considered as node, and Z and R is nothing but the gain factor, okay. So this is your second, from second equation we got this expression, signal flow graph, V0 equal to Is into R2. Now what we can see, this is your Is, this is your V0S, right. Now these two node already present here, this is your Is, this is your V0S, right. So we can take this one and we can place it here, that means here we can connect this way, and this one becomes your R2, as simple as that, V0 equal to Is into R2. So this becomes the total signal flow graph of this particular network, okay. So this is the total signal flow graph. Now we can apply Meissen's gain formula very easily to find out its transfer function. So what is the loop forward path? That is this factor into R2. So R2 into this, this is your T1 loop, we have only single loop, okay, L1, R2 into minus of this factor, that is your loop 1. So delta equal to 1 minus L1, there is only one loop, so there is no point that we have to calculate for, or we have to look for two non-touching loop, because there is only one loop. So 1 minus L1, so it will become plus. So we can calculate that and we can find out delta. What is the delta 1 value now? That is equal to 1. One forward path, one loop, that is touching with each other. So formula, delta 1 T1 divided by delta. Okay. We know T1 value. Okay. We know delta value, delta 1 equal to 1, so we can find out the transfer function, okay. So this is another type of problem, okay. Let us take another example of that. So this is another network we have taken, okay, and we have to find out, we have to draw the signal flow graph, and from that we have to find out the transfer function. Or the problem is, we have to find out transfer function from this network. Now we have to find out its Laplace, okay. So convert into its Laplace domain. C becomes 1 by SC1, 1 by SC2, R1, R2 remain the same, and current we can assume as I1s, I2s and voltage as G0s. Okay, so here we have two loop current and one voltage. Okay, so we can find I1s will be equal to what? This is the current that is flowing, that is your I1, right? Here the current is I1 minus I2, and here the current is I2, here also the current is I2 from the circuit. Okay, so I1 is equal to what? This is your VI, this is your V1, and this node is V0. Okay, so I1 is equal to what? VI minus V1 divided by Z, where Z equal to 1 by SC1. So VI by V1 divided by 1 minus SC1. So this is the equation. Now V1 voltage, okay, that is equal to what? This voltage with respect to ground, that means what? Voltage drop across R1, which is nothing but I1 minus I2 into R1. So V1 equal to I1 minus I2 into R1. So we are finding I1, then V1. Now we have to find out I2. I2 is current flowing through this branch. Okay, this same current is flowing, but we can consider only this. Then what we can write? V1 minus V0 divided by Z, right? So V1 by minus V0 divided by 1 by SC2. So this is the equation. Now V0 is what? V0 is nothing but I2 into R2. I2 into R2. So we got these four equations. VI is known parameter. V0 you have to find out. Okay. You know value of C1, C2, R1, R2. So what are the unknown parameter? This current I1, this node voltage, intermediate node voltage V1, I2 and V0. So we got these four parameters. Okay. From that we have to draw the signal flow graph. Same way that we did. So here I1 equal to what? VI into SC1. So I1 is your node, SC1 into VI. So here we have one VI node multiplied by a factor SC1, okay, and minus V0 into SC1. That means we have a factor V0 node, and we can connect this by a factor minus SC1. Okay, so VI1 equal to VI into SC1 minus V1 into minus SC1. So this is your V1. Okay, this is not V0 but V1. So you have to write here V1. Okay, so this is the signal flow graph from equation 1. From equation 2, what we can write? V1 equal to I1 R1 minus I2 R2. So we have V1 node. Okay, here we have I1 node. Okay, V1 equal to I1 into R1. So here the factor is R1, and we have I2 node. Okay, from that it is coming negative feedback with negative sign minus R1. V1 equal to I1 R1, I2 minus R1. Okay, this is from second equation. Third equation, same thing. I2 equal to V1 into SC2 minus V0 into SC2. So here we must have this minus sign. Okay, and last one, V0 equal to what? I2 into R2. So we got four signal flow graph from four equation, and now we have to combine those. That is the point. How you can combine? You can see here VI V1, and here it is I1, and for second case I1 VI I2. So this one we can put it here. Okay, so here it will be R1, right? Then from V1 we have this one, this is your I2, right? So this will be your, if you over superimpose this one into first, okay, then we can put this one into here. Okay, so V1 and I2, so between V1 and I2 this one we have another one, then this one into here we can superimpose. So I2 and this is your V0. Okay, this one we can put it here. Okay, this one we can put it here like this way. Okay, and this one we can put it here. So we can get, if we put all this way, this one will be your overall signal flow graph. vi i1 v1 vi i1 v1, okay. Then between i1 v1 we have r1, okay. From v1 to i2 minus r1, okay. Now v1 to i2 we have sc2. From i2 to v0 we have minus sc2 minus sc2, and between i2 v0 we have r2, okay. So this is your overall signal flow graph from that particular circuit. Now we can find out, or we can apply Mason's gain formula to find out the transfer function. Okay. Now from this, what we can see, we have only one forward path, okay, whose gain is sc1 into r1 into sc2 into r2. Okay. So that gain is this one, s square r1 r2 c1 c2. We have three loops here, 1, 2, 3, okay. Values are sr1c1 minus sr1c2 minus and sr2c2 minus, okay. Now what we can see here, l1 and l2 l3 l1 and l3 these two loops are non-touching, because these two node and this has these two node, those are not common. So L1, L3 are non-touching loops. Okay. So delta equal to what? 1 minus individual loop gain plus 2 non-touching loop gain. Okay. We can put L1, L2, L3 value. Okay. L1, L3 we have to multiply. It will be plus. That factor comes here. Okay. So we get the value of delta. Now delta 1 equal to what? If you look, all these loops, these three loops are touching with this forward path. So delta 1 equal to 1, we can write directly without any problem. So what we will have? T1 into delta 1, T1 we know, okay. T1 we know, delta 1, 1, 1 plus this delta, okay. We have taken this S common factor, S square common factor, okay, that is the part. Anyway, so this is the transfer function of this particular network, okay. How we are doing that? From that network, we are finding the Laplace transform, then we are writing the equations, node and loop equations, okay. From that, we are finding the from each equation, we are finding the signal flow graph, then we are merging all those signal flow graph together. From that signal flow graph, we have to find out transfer function applying Mason's gain formula. Okay. Now let us solve another type of problem. Okay. This is a very interesting one, because this is for multiple input system. Okay. Multiple input. So if we have a block diagram of multiple input, we can find out transfer function applying superposition theorem, right? Now what will happen if it is signal flow graph? Okay. If it is signal flow graph, we have to do the same way. Okay. So we have to convert that into signal flow graph from the block diagram. How we can convert? R1 we can take one node. Okay. From that G1 goes to this summer. Okay. And from that G2 comes. Okay, from that summer to another summer, that means another node. Okay, we have this, there is no block, so it is gain is 1. Into that summer, okay, we have R2. From this, we have G3, then your output node. Okay, and we have taken a dummy node here for output node. It can be C also, there is no problem. Okay, from that, we have feedback minus H1. Because we have a minus sign here, it is connected to this summer point, okay, this point. So this is the signal flow graph. So what we have to do, we have to apply same concept, superposition theorem. So what we are doing, if we consider, if you want to find out C by R1 transfer function, we have to consider R2 equal to 0, okay. Then this part is not there. we have one forward path and another forward path. Okay, two forward paths are there, G1, G3, G2, G3. So this is two forward path. We have only one loop, okay, that is G3 minus H1. Okay, one loop means there is no concept of non-touching loop, two non-touching loop. So 1 minus L1, so this is your delta. Now if you want to find out delta 1 and delta 2, okay, delta 1, delta 2, both values are 1. Why? Because loop forward path 1, this loop is touching with that. For forward path 2, this loop is also touching. Okay, so we can find out T1 into delta 1 plus T2 into 1 divided by delta. So this is the transfer function C by R1. Now similarly we can find out C by R2, okay, when we have to make your R1 equal to 0, R1 equal to 0, okay. So in that case we can modify this signal flow graph into this. How? If R1 equal to 0, okay, if R1 equal to 0, then what will happen? What is the value that will come at this particular node? 0 into G2, it will be 0. 0 into G1, that will be 0. So this node, we will not have any value due to this G1, G2, because it is multiplied with 0. So what we will have? R2 going through this way, this is forward path and this is your feedback path. Okay. So that we are getting only. This G1 and G2 factor is omitted, or we have to neglect it, because it is multiplied with R1 is 0. So it has no effect. So this is your forward path now. Okay. This is your forward path now. So forward path is what? Only 1 into G3. So GT is forward path and your loop is, feedback loop is this. Okay. G3 into minus H1. Okay. So delta equal to 1 plus that, right? And delta 1 equal to 1, because this loop is touching with the forward path. So we can find C by R2 very easily. Okay. So this is the problem. Okay. So this is an example how we can solve it if we have multiple input system, multiple input single output system. From block diagram we can convert into signal flow. From that we can find out C by R1 and C by R2. Then we can add those two, okay, to find out the overall transfer function. Okay. So this is another type of problem. Okay. Okay, so now let us solve some problem. Okay, those I have taken form. Okay, so now let me solve some problem that I have taken from gate examination. Okay, so this is a signal flow graph. Okay, we have to find out transfer function x2 by x1 and some answers are given. Okay, now how to solve that? So simple, we have to apply the Mason's gain formula. How many forward path? We have seen this is one forward path. Okay, and we have another forward path. Okay. So we have two forward path, okay, and we have two loops. Okay, we have two loops, fine. So now Mason's gain formula we can apply. So 1 minus sum of individual loop gain plus sum of product of two non-touching loop minus sum of product of three non-touching loop, like that way. Okay, so what we can see here, that P1 is nothing but RSU. Delta 1 equal to what? For this forward path, this loop is not touching. So one delta one equal to one minus f g. Okay, p two equal to what? This is your p two forward path two, e f h. Okay, and delta two equal to what? This loop is not touching with this forward path. That is one minus s into t. Okay, so delta is what? Nothing but one minus individual loop gain. Okay. ST plus GH, FG plus ST, and these two loops are non-touching, so that gain we can take care. Okay, that part we can write in this particular form. Okay, because here we have seen that answer as written in this particular form. Okay, so we have written this in particular this particular form. Now, what we can find out? What is the gain formula? X2 by X1. That will be equal to what? P1 delta 1, okay, P1 delta 1 by delta plus P2 delta 2 by delta. Okay, so we can cancel this part and we can find out this is the answer. Okay, that we can get the answer. So we have to modify that result so that we can get the answer. Okay, now let us solve another problem. This is the easiest one. So what we can see, this is the one factor, that is the forward path. What is the gain? A, B, C, D is the gain. Okay, fine. Delta 1 will be equal to what? 1, because we have three loops are there. All these three loops are touching with this forward path, so that will be 1. Okay, now 1 minus this value. Okay, what are the value of that? That is B into E. Okay, plus C into F plus D into G. Okay, then this loop 1, loop 2 non-touching with each other. So plus B E D G. Okay, so that is the transfer function. So what we can answer, see here, A B C D divided by 1 minus B E plus C F plus D G plus B E into D G. This is because of non-touching loop. So this is your right answer. So this is the simple type of question. This is a question from gate examination. Okay, so this is another problem. This is very interesting one. So here, what is the this is the part, forward path. Gain is g1, g2, g3, g4. Okay, this is the gain. Now what we have? 1 minus, what is the loop? We can have, this is your one loop. Okay, so that is your minus g4. Okay, then this is your another loop whose value is minus g3 g4 minus 1. Then we can have another loop, this one, that is minus g2 g3 g4. Okay, and we have another loop, that is your this self loop, okay, which is minus 1. Fine. Now we can look for plus non-touching loop. Which loops are non-touching with each other? This loop 1, okay, is non-touching with this self loop. So what is the value we can get? Minus g4 into minus 1. Okay, so it will be plus g4, right? This loop, this L2 is touching, also not touching with this second loop here, that is also non-touching with this self loop, but this third loop is touching. This node is common. So what we can have? Minus g4 plus non-touching loop. Here it is L2, value is g2 g3 g4 minus 1 into minus 1, so that will be plus g3 g4, right? So what we can have? That is this minus 1 minus plus, so it will be 2. Okay, so at denominator we will have 2 plus g4. Okay, here we have another g4. Okay, so we will have 2 g4. Okay, 2 g4, right? G3 g4 we have twice. Okay, here minus minus plus, so 2 g3 g4, right? And we have minus minus plus g1 g3 g2 g3 g4 g2 g3 g4. Okay, so now see this answer C is the right answer. g1 g2 g3 g4, 2 plus g2 g3 g4, okay, plus 2 g3 g4, plus 2 g4. Okay, so this will be the right answer. So here what we can see that we have a self loop. Okay, now one loop is non-touching with this self loop, that we have to consider. Okay, that's why these two factor comes, and for this self loop this factor comes into picture. Okay, this is for this self loop, and self loop is non-touching with two other loops. Okay, this loop 1 and loop 2, that's why this two non-touching loop pair comes into picture. So this is one of the most important problem that we have to solve. Now this is a very easy one to solve it. Okay, so what we can see here, we have to find out C by R. So what we can see, we have one gain G. Okay, delta 1 equal to 1, because these two loops are touching with each other. Okay, what we'll have, 1 minus h1 h2, so both will become plus h1 plus h2, and plus these two loops are non-touching with each other, so it will be minus h1 into minus h2, that is h1 plus h2. That we can write as in this particular form, 1 plus h1 plus h2 plus h1 h2. Okay, so B should be the right answer. From that we can get this particular answer. Okay, so this is the problem I have taken from a GATE examination. This is a very simple problem. Okay, similarly we can have this kind of problem. Okay, we have to find out the value. Now here we have only one forward path, the gain is 3 into 1 2 into 1 6. Okay, how many loops are there? 1 2 3. We have taken self loop into consideration. Okay, L1 is minus 1, L2 is minus 2, L3 is minus 6. Okay, now we have two non-touching loop, this loop and this loop, non-touching with each other. With this loop, these two loops are touching. So L1, L2 is nothing but minus 1, minus 2, 2. So delta will be what? 1 minus L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L1, L2. Okay, so those value, loop value, we can put it here. Okay, and we can calculate delta. P1 is known. Now delta 1 equal to 1, all the loops are touching with this forward path, so we can find out C by R. So this is one simple problem. We have to apply the concept of Mason gain formula. Now here we have to take care of this self loop. Okay, I have not taken any example in previous problems taking self loop into consideration. I have taken these two examples taking self loop. These three problems I have taken using self loop, and that we have to consider as a loop. Okay, whether it is self loop, but we have to consider as a loop, non-touching loop we have to consider, and we have to take care of that part. Okay, now this is another type of problem they used to ask, that is here G1, G2, H1 values are given, H2 value you have to find out. Okay, when X5 by X1 value is given, that means you have to find out the X5 by X1 formula. You have to put it equal to 3 by 4. You have to put G1, G2, H1 value, H2 value you have to find out from the formula. That's all. Okay, so in that point, this is your forward path, one forward path. We have another forward path, so G1, one forward path, another one G1, G2, one loop is here, minus G1, H1, another loop is total one. Okay, G1 minus H2, we have another loop starting from here, and we can go this way to this. Okay, how many forward path here? With respect to that, find out, try to find out the loops, G1, G2 minus H2. Okay, so delta 1, all the loops are touching with loop forward path, and all the loops are touching with this second forward path also. So delta 1, delta 2, basically 1. both are 1. So g1 plus g1 g2, so we can take g1 common, 1 plus g2, and 1 minus all these term, so we will get this one delta, and we don't have any non-touching loop, two non-touching loop. Now we can put those values. What value we can put? We can put the value of g1, g2, h1, okay. Then we can get one x5 by x1 is known, so h2 we get one equation, and we can find the value of h2, okay. This is the simple problem. Now we can have another problem. This is also from a gate examination. So here what we can see, this is your RS, this is your CS, so this is your forward path. These are nothing but loop, okay. This is one loop, this is second loop, this is your third loop, okay. So we have three loops are there. These are not forward path, because from input to output is the forward path. So this is the trick of this problem, okay. You cannot come like this way, then we are going to feedback path, okay. Forward path is only one, value is 1 into 1 1. We have three loops, okay. Their values are minus 2 by s, minus 3 by s, minus 24 by s, okay. And we can see that this L1 and L3 are non-touching loops, okay. This L1 loop and this L3 loops are not touching with each other, fine. So we can find out L1 into L3. L2, L3 touching, L1, L2 also touching, okay. So we can write the delta, 1 minus individual loop gain plus non-touching loop. So we can solve it for delta, okay. Now delta 1 equal to what? Now let me discard these lines and let me show you what is the delta 1 now. Delta 1 means this is your forward path. And this forward path, this loop is touching with this node. Now this loop and this loop, these two loops are not touching with this forward path. So delta 1 equal to what? 1 minus, this is your L2 plus L3. So that value of L2, L3 you have to put it here, you will get delta 1. Then we can apply directly the Mason's gain formula, P1 delta 1 by delta. P1 you know 1, delta 1 already we find out, we have put delta value and we can calculate what is the result and we can get the answer, okay. So this is the way we can solve this type of problem. Now this is another problem, okay. This is the easy part, because we have one single g1, g2, g3, g4, okay. We have three loops, okay, all are having minus sign, and we can see this loop and this loop are non-touching with each other. So what will be the answer? That will be g1, g2, g3, g4, okay, 1 minus of this minus term, so become plus. So g1, g2 into h1 with positive sign, g3, g4, h2 with positive sign, then g2, g3, h3 with positive sign, plus these two loop gain you have to multiply, non-touching loop. So minus minus become plus, g1, g2, g3, g4, h1, h2. So this one will be your right answer. So this is the way we have to solve this kind of problem, okay. So let us see another problem. This is also taken from gate. So here we have two forward path. This is your one forward path, this is your second forward path, okay. And what we can see that P1 value equal to 4 into 3 into 2, that is 6 into 4, 24. P2 value equal to 5 into 1, 5, okay, 24. Now we have three loops, you can see here directly. So loop 1 value is minus 2, loop 2 minus 3, loop 3 minus 4. Now you have to be very careful to find out loop. Now for this particular forward path, if you consider this way, okay, this is another loop, right. starting from this node, going back like this way, then value will be 5 into minus 1 minus 1 plus minus. So another loop is there, that value is minus 5. Okay. Now what we can see, non-touching loop, this L1 and this L3 non-touching, right? L1, L3, L2 is touching with L1, L2 is touching with L3, and L4 is nothing but touching with all. So L1, L3, that value will be 2 into 8, 8, minus, minus become plus. So what we can write is that delta value equal to 1 minus, okay, minus 2, so that will be plus 2, okay, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 8, okay, so 5, 9, 5, 5, 10, that is 8, okay, 8, 3, 6, okay, 6, 10, plus 8, 18, plus 25, that is equal to 23, right. Now we have to find out numerator value. What is that? For this first forward path, okay, it is delta 1 equal to 1, because all the loops are touching with that forward path. That will be 24 plus, what will happen here? For the second one, gain is 5, but here for this particular path, we can see this loop is non-touching. That means 5 into what we can write, delta 1 equal to 1 minus minus 3, so plus. That will be 4 into 5, 20 plus 24, 44. So answer is 44 divided by 23. D is the correct answer. Okay. So this is the way you solve. If you forget to take this particular loop, okay, your answer will be wrong. What loop? This is the main loop that comes. Okay. This is the loop. If you forget to take this loop, if you have taken only L1, L2, L3, then your answer will be wrong. Okay. Now this is a very simple question. Okay. So we have this one forward path, four loop, okay, and we have how many non-touching loop? We can have L1, L3, okay. So L1 plus L2 plus L3 plus L4, okay, then plus L1, L3, okay, plus L1, L4, L1, L4, then L2, L3, L2, L4, those are non-touching. So we have another two term. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then 1 minus that. So total 9 terms are there, and again here G1, G2, G3, G4. So what we can see here, that in this particular answer, if you multiply these two, okay, we will get 9 factor. 3 into 3, so we will get 9 factor. Others are not given the 9 result, okay, at denominator. So this should be the answer. You can cross verify. Okay. Now this is the last problem to find out the gain value. Okay. Now here we have only one forward path, and this is your self loop. So forward path is 5, delta is 1, delta 1, and gain is 1 minus this loop, which is 0.5. Okay. So 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5. 0.5 means 5 by 10. So 10 goes up, 5 cancel out. So answer is 10. So we can find out very easily. So this is all about this signal flow graph. Okay. How to solve using Mason's gain formula. I have solved so many problems. So you can practice all those problems. Thank you so much. I will upload the next video on a new topic. topic. Okay, so thank you so much.